Hi there. So when I was a kid, I would spend hours sitting on the bottom step of the stairs in our house on one of these. This is a BT746 rotary dial telephone, and I'll be talking to my mates while my dad would be prowling up and down the hall going, how long have you been on the phone for? Don't you know how much this is costing? Maybe somebody's trying to phone us. And I didn't really care because this was part of the inherent tension between a parent and a child. Anyway, about 15 years ago, in a wave of nostalgia, I picked one of these up on eBay and bought it for my wife as a present. And for several years, we had it plugged into our landline at home and we used to use it. But of course, who has or uses a landline these days? So it was gathering dust in my 9-year-old's bedroom, and I was feeling pretty sorry about that because it was getting slowly trashed. So over half term, I thought, well, I wonder if it's possible just to resurrect this and get it into use again. So I looked into getting a Raspberry Pi Zero, putting it inside and, you know, trying to use it that way. But the electroacoustic system in there is pretty different from the kind of thing that a device like that would expect. But also, to make the thing ring requires 50 volts AC input. And you can get that, but it's a pretty expensive proposition to get a power supply to do that. So it looked like it wasn't going to be very cost effective. Until I stumbled across this device. So this is a LIGO Blue Wave, and these things are basically end of life being remaindered now. So I picked this up for £20, and it does exactly what I need. So you plug the phone in there, this becomes a Bluetooth bridge. You can pair it to three different mobile phones, and if somebody rings one of those mobile phones, it makes this bad boy ring, and you can pick it up, you can hold the call, and if you pick up the handset, you hear a dial tone. You can use the rotary dial to place the call. Of course, you're only going to do that once for the novelty, because dialing a long number on a rotary dial is a massive pain in the backside. But even so, it's pretty cool. The design of these things is absolutely classic. It's very comfortable for placing a long phone call on, certainly much more comfortable than holding an iPhone up to your ear. And yeah, so this has been a pretty cool project to undertake over half term with the kids. Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Doing good.
You can hear me all right?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Okay. Lunchtime?
Yeah.
Ace. All right. See you later. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, so the second half-term project that I've been getting my two younger kids involved in has been games piracy. Now, bear with me for a second on this. When I was a kid and I had one of the first waves of 8-bit home computers, our pocket money would run out pretty quickly, and we couldn't afford to get the games that we wanted, and so pretty soon we moved on to trying to wrap our heads around how to copy games. So all sorts of Heath Robinson arrangements sprang up to be able to copy from cassette to cassette, and then as the manufacturers got more and more sophisticated with their copy protection, it was a bit of an arms race to try and get ahead of that. Now, that was obviously not entirely desirable from a moral point of view, but from a technical learning point of view, it was amazing. So we figured out a huge amount of stuff in a short amount of time. Now, these days, it's really virtually impossible to copy and break the piracy on a console game. But I wanted to try to open the door to this kind of possibility for my children, to help them to learn and get their heads around this kind of thing. And so I got them this. So this looks like a Nintendo Game Boy, right? But if we take a look at the end, USB port, Ethernet port, it's not a Game Boy. This is a case for a Raspberry Pi 4, and this is a Pi Boy DMG running something called RetroPie. RetroPie is an emulator which supports not only elementary, rudimentary Game Boy games like this one, but Nintendo Entertainment System games, SNES games, Nintendo 64 games, and even PlayStation games. So these ROMs are available on the internet. The manufacturers, I guess, turn a bit of a blind eye to it. And they can be downloaded and installed on this thing and played, and it's a pretty decent experience. And not only that, because it's a Raspberry Pi, you can plug an HDMI cable into it, plug it into the TV, plug controllers into the USB port, and it can act as a little mini console. Now, that's pretty cool in its own right, but what's even more cool is that realization when the penny drops that not only have they got a pretty cool games machine here, but this is something that they can start playing with and changing and modifying themselves. So two pennies dropped this morning for my 9-year-old son. The first one was, Okay, I can run a Minecraft server on this, like a proper modded Minecraft server on this. Yes, you can. And then the second thing was with my 11-year-old who said, so Dad, I can SSH in and I can open a terminal and I can do whatever I like on that. And it's like, yes, you can. So, you know, as a steer to try to get your younger kids maybe playing around and tinkering with the technology in a way that might help them to start doing some real deep learning, I'd really encourage you to look into devices like this and explore something like this, because it's pretty cool. It's pretty great to play these kinds of games on there. But not only that, it is going to open a door to something else, something even better for them. As for this particular game, not only does this bring back memories of too much time spent wasted in front of a console as a young adult, but what a hell of a soundtrack this game had. That's it for this week. I'm Gareth. I'll see you on the next video.